lost everything. 23 years, you lose everything. What does that look like for somebody so young? Lost, not having anybody to rent to. God, baby, please, that's it, that's all I have. Because I was turning to that drug, turning to that juice. But God, please, if you're real, that's what I'm saying. God, please, I'm begging. Please, take this from me, Lord, please. And yeah, we do that. We choose God as a movie. Oh, I got it. God saved me from this. Now I'm going to come back to what I was doing. And yeah, God hung on that cross for that person too. So nobody's just going to use him. But no, God left the vision, not just everlasting life. People think, oh, I don't care what happens after I die, after I leave this world. People don't care about that. But what about while you're in this world? Don't you want peace? Don't you want joy? Don't you want to feel complete, whole? Because you think everything in this world is making you whole. But no, you're empty before, and then it leaves you feel even worse. I know how that feels. I'm not just standing here telling you, oh, I'm such a great Christian. Oh, I'm such a great follower of Christ. Because no, I'm not. I just realize I need help. Each and every day I need help. Because you know how easy it is to turn back to the old things I used to do. I'm tempted every single day. Because you're not walking past me without cutting your head. Yeah, this is my place too. I understand. You're trying to find peace at the bottom of that place. You're not going to find me, no matter how many drugs you smoke. You're not going to have any peace. But there is peace. There's a prison of peace. Yeah. That he brought a crown. So you wouldn't have to be anxious no more. He brought a crown of thorns. So you can have a mind of peace. Do you know what a mind of peace is doing right? No, you don't. You don't. Because when you're sitting by yourself, you have all this stuff going to be ahead. Will I take my life today or will it be tomorrow? Prayerfully, you have tomorrow. God has to give you peace. I'm not a preacher. I'm nobody. I'm a child of the Most High God. That's it. That's all I know. That's what I care about. God, I'm a child of the Most High God. All I feel is all I know is Jesus Christ, baby. That's all I know. The only reason I'm a sister is the Holy Spirit putting in my heart to say it to you, because somebody out there, I don't know who it is, it's a whole lot of people out here, but somebody needs to hear what I'm saying. Somebody needs to know you're not alone. Because sometimes you think, I'm the only person dealing with this. I felt that way too. That's why I kept my pain to myself. I didn't tell my family. I didn't tell my cousin. I didn't tell my friends. My friends are my friends. Your friends ain't gonna keep y'all from hell. You need to get some real friends that's gonna tell you that you love with Jesus Christ. And not gonna just pass you a plug or pass you a bottle. Don't get your friends. They're gonna sit here with you. They ain't killing your body. They're killing your soul. They're killing your soul. Listen in that prophet, and we gave the whole world for the place of his soul. That's all we have, each and every one of us. I don't know, some people walking around with demons, so I don't know if we really have a soul. But most of us out here have souls, and they're crying out for something. And you think it's a plan, you think it's a bottle, you think it's death, you think it's something. You talk about all that bread, I never thought food was like, but I feel a void. That void will never be filled by anything of this world. Until you find Jesus Christ. We often talk about the love of Jesus Christ. Yes, he is love. Love is what hung on the cross. Love ain't love. This world tells you love is love. This world, tells you be who you want to be. God created you to be that man, to be that woman, to be that child. God created you to be exactly what you are. There's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with you. I don't care what this world tells you. Nothing is wrong with you. You're perfect. They're doing the right thing. We're afraid of just the way they are, but we're also weepy. We're also weepy, we're also weepy. Our minds are weepy. And that's why we need Jesus Christ, because he was perfect. He was a perfect sacrifice. He had to sacrifice animals, sacrifice you, sacrifice that idea he had to leave. But no, Jesus was a one-time sacrifice. A one-time sacrifice for each and every one of us. And not only did he hang on that cross and bear our sins, and bear our anxieties, and bear our depression, and bear that hurt, and bear that burden, and bear that pain that our family left to us, that our friends left to us. But he was also raised again. He can be touched with our iniquities. He can be touched with the pain. Because not anyone, Jesus died. He went to hell to get everyone out of here that believes in him. So he even knows the people that would like to hell how that would feel. He even knows that he was going to stay in hell because he was a perfect sacrifice. He stood at the right hand of the Father. There is a seat for you. There is waking you up this morning. So even if you choose to not believe in him, he's still waiting for you. He still loves you. We don't care that you don't love him. He loves you. And some of us say, no, we don't know him. He is a God for us all, right? Real love.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm talking about real love. Yeah, we're talking about Jesus. That's the only real love there is. It's not this world. Jesus is the real love. Not that this world says he is love. You can't just love who you love because it makes you feel good. And I'm not here to preach no hate. I'm not here to talk down no hate. Because I gotta look at my own life. What has Jesus gone through? What am I still dealing with? What am I still battling? So how can I look at you and say, yo, Jesus is preaching? You know, the pastor said, not me. Y'all be mad at the street preachers, y'all be mad at the people trying to tell y'all about the love of Jesus Christ, but we trying to save y'all. We love y'all so much, we're standing out here, stretching our voices, being submitted to the Holy Spirit that told us to come out here. No, we can't be doing nothing better with our time because we love y'all. We love. That's what we feel for y'all. Real love. Not what that man told you how you feel. Not what that woman told you how to feel. Real love. That's why we're standing out here. Y'all may be mad at us. Oh, they said love. They said annoying. I'm not going to stay home. No. No. We're not going home because we love y'all. Jesus loves y'all. That's why we call y'all on this wall. And tell you that I belong to Jesus Christ, but at the end of the day, you have a choice. But you know what the other thing he did? Hanging on the other side of Jesus, he said, please, Jesus, remember me in paradise. Remember me. And he said, Jesus told him, today you will be with me in paradise. That's what Jesus told a thief. Oh, he could be down with his faith. He knew he was hanging in the middle of the Son of God, the Son of Man. He was hanging there with him. So he didn't have a Bible in front of him. That is the Holy Scripture, the one and only Holy Scripture. So he didn't have that. All he had was his faith. And he knew that he was a sinner. That's it. That's it. That's all he knew. Repent. Pray for what you know. I know that's hard. Turning from this world, we grow up just knowing this is all I know. This is all I know, this is all my family taught me. But you can live a new life in Christ. A new life. You still don't love yourself. But now you have peace when you love yourself. Because doesn't it start to go through stuff? And you gotta walk around like everything's okay? I know that stuff. That hurts. I still go through stuff. But Jesus overcame the world for me. Choose Jesus. He's the only one that hung on a cross for you. He's the only one that bore your sin. Sin is anything that keeps you away from God. And all of us, me, my name, all of us, have seen the fallen spirit of the glory of God, because you can compare yourself to the next person. I'm not doing what that person is doing. I'm not as drunk like that person. I'm not just like that person. I'm not just like that person. Compare yourself to God. You're trash compared to God. I'm trash compared to God. But he still says, what's your name? So don't compare yourself to the next person. Because you're still going to be somebody doing better than you. Compare yourself to God. And you're going to fall short every time. But with Jesus Christ, you can be made better. You can be made righteous. You can have somebody stand in front of you, in front of God for you. The same way that you got to go in front of a judge when you commit a crime, is the same thing that Jesus does for us. Jesus says, no, wipe that off me. I pay for that. But if you go in front of God yourself, like, God, I was a good person. I fed the homeless. I did this, I didn't cuss, I didn't do this, I didn't do that. So don't say, I don't care. Because what about that one time you stole that pencil? What about that one time you lied to your parents? Every sin, no matter how small, no matter how small, big sin, it all equates to death. It all equates to death. And it all will separate you from God. And when you humble yourself and realize that I wasn't just placed here, I'm not just here because my dad and my mom got together. I'm here because God created me for a purpose. God was just with me and wonderfully made. That ain't just a, these scriptures ain't a lie. Go to the scriptures and read it for yourself. Stop listening to what people are telling you God says. Oh, the Bible say this, the Bible say that. Oh, there was favor in the Bible. You know why God chose in all of that? Because he wanted to show how wicked people are. It's not because God is wicked, it's because man is wicked. God allowed all that to happen. There's a difference between God allowing something to happen to you because you can grow from that. You can turn and be like, I need a savior. I need somebody. God shows us how wicked man is, how wicked our parents are. Look at yourself. So I know a lot of y'all know me. I don't care. I care about you. I'm telling you about the love of Jesus Christ. That's it. I'm a preacher. I'm nobody. I ain't got a spirit. I ain't do nothing. This is nothing but the Holy Spirit speaking through me. So God loves you. God created you for a purpose. But don't think that God that created you will not leave you. He says, I will never leave nor forsake you. But don't think, because you chose to be a part of him, that he will not step away from you. He will take his hand off your life, and that's painful. For the God of the universe, the Creator, to take his hand off your life. Yeah, drag your life that way. God, you are my father. You are my living.